Hello, dear friends. In the sixth lecture of the Erasmus Ecclesiastical Law of spring semester, before passing to the special ecclesiastical territory of Mount Athos, I would like to explain the Article 18, paragraph 8 . It says that farmlands belonging to the patriarchal monasteries of Agia Anastasia Pharmakoliptria in Chalkidiki, of Latades in Thessaloniki, and Ioannis the Evangelist Theologos in Patmos, with the exception of the dependencies thereof, cannot be subject to expropriation. Likewise, the property in Greece of the patriarchates of Alexandria, Antiochia, and Jerusalem, and that of the holy monastery of Mount Sinai, cannot be subject to expropriation. The paragraph 8 of the Article 18 exempts the Orthodox organizations enumerated in it from the expropriation of their farmlands, the expropriations of ownership for public utility according to the special law, state law. Those Orthodox organizations are patriarchal monasteries enumerated, Agia Anastasia Pharmakolitria in Chalkidiki, Vlatades in Thessaloniki, Ioannis the Evangelist Theologos in Patmos. But farmlands belonging to their dependencies are not subject of exemption from the expropriation are exempted also. The patriarchates enumerated in that constitutional disposition, Alexandria, Antiochia, Jerusalem, and the holy monastery of Mount Sinai. I have the opinion, de legge ferenta, that all the Orthodox autocephal churches have to be enumerated in that constitutional disposition when a constitutional amendment is done. And now I will pass to the explanation, to the explication of the Article 105 on the regime of the Mount Athos. Paragraph 1. The Athos Peninsula, extending beyond Megali Bigline, constituting the region of Agion Oros, shall, in accordance with its ancient privileged status, be a self-governed part of the Greek state, whose sovereignty their own shall remain intact. Spiritually, Agion Oros shall come under the direct jurisdiction of the Ecumenical Patriarchate. All persons leading a monastic life their own acquire Greek citizenship without further formalities upon admission as novices or monks. I explain paragraph 1 of the article 105. In the beginning, this paragraph gives us the territory, that is the limits of Mount Athos. Beyond Megali Vigla, third peninsula, beyond Megali Vigla. This is the region of Mount Athos. This paragraph says also that it enjoys an ancient privileged status and in accordance with its ancient privileged status it is a self-governed part of Greek state whose sovereignty thereon shall remain intact. The sovereignty of Mount Athos belongs to the Greek state, but it constitutes a self-governed part, self-administered part of the Greek state, because this self-administration is in accordance, in conformity with its ancient privileged status. Spiritually, Mount Athos is under the direct jurisdiction of the Ecumenical Patriarchate. This means that the Bishop of Mount Athos is the Ecumenical Patriarch. Whose name is referred to during the ecclesiastical services in the churches or houses of prayer in Mount Athos. Third verse of the first paragraph. All persons leading a monastic life their own acquire Greek citizenship without further formalities upon admission as novices or monks. As it concerns the acquisition of Greek citizenship without further formalities by foreign novices or monks, this is provided by the third verse of the first paragraph of the article 105. But the law does not follow the Constitution, despite the fact that the Constitution is the supreme law. So, the Greek law that is the existing code of migration as the former law for the migrants provide a type of visa and a type of permission of residence for the foreigners who want to be novices or monks in Mount Athos. For that topic, there is a different opinion between from one part the former Greek governments and the Ecumenical Patriarchate of Constantinople, and from the other part of the Holy Community of Mount Athos, that is the union of all the sovereign, that is the administrative monastery, which is 20 number of Mount Athos. Holy Community of Mount Athos understands this disposition as it is literally written. All persons leading a monastic life thereon, acquire legal Greek citizenship without further formalities upon admission as novices or monks. But the former governments with the cooperation of the Ecumenical Patriarchate have imposed a limited regime different than provided by the Constitution. For that reason, they have imposed through the law codes on migration the obligation for the foreigners who want to become novices or monks in Mount Athos to acquire a special visa for novice or monk of Mount Athos and a special permission of residence for novices or monks of Mount Athos. Now we pass to the second paragraph of the article 105. Agion Oros shall be governed according to its regime by its 20 holy monasteries, among which the entire Athos peninsula is divided. The territory of the peninsula shall be exempt from expropriation. The administration of Agion Oros shall be exercised by representatives of the holy monasteries constituting the holy community. No change whatsoever shall be permitted in the administrative system or in the number of monasteries of Agion Oros or in their hierarchical order or in their position to their subordinate dependencies. Heterodox or schismatic persons shall be prohibited from dealing their own. In the first verse of the second paragraph, it is written that the proprietors of all the Agion Oros territory are 20 holy monasteries, which are sovereign or administrative monasteries, among which the entire Athos Peninsula is divided. That is, in Mount Athos, in the territory of Mount Athos, there are 20 ownerships corresponding to the 20 monasteries, from which other inferior monasteries under different names depend on. The territory, the whole territory of the peninsula of Mount Athos is exempt from expropriation. The second verset of the paragraph second of the article 105 says that the administration of Mount Athos as a whole belong to the holy community. So there are two levels of administration in Mount Athos. The territory of each monastery from the 20 sovereign or administrative one is administered by the respective holy monastery. And the whole territory of Mount Athos is administered by the holy community, which is the union. It's a body expressing the union of the 20 holy monasteries. The 20 holy monasteries are sending representatives to that holy community. The structure of holy community, that is the structure of holy community, is composed of the representatives of holy monasteries. The different types of representation of the holy monasteries in the holy community are provided by the constitutional charter of the Mount Athos. One form of structure of the holy community is that in which each monastery sends one representative. The second form of the structure of the holy community is that in which the holy monastery sent two representatives, the superior and the ordinary representative. And there is also another third structure of the holy community, that in which the holy monasteries sent their superiors and two representatives. The competencies or fits structure of the whole community are provided by the internal law of Mount Athos. In the third verse, it is clarified that there is an order of the 20 holy monasteries, and this order cannot be changed. This order is provided in the constitutional charter of the Mount Athos, but the constitution in this third verse of the second paragraph provides that no change shall be permitted in the administrative system that is administrative system 20 sovereign or administrative monasteries and holy community. No change. No change in the number of monasteries of Mount Athos. Only 20 sovereign administrative monasteries. No change in their hierarchical order, which monastery is first, which second, which third, etc. No change in the relation of the monasteries, of the 20 monasteries, with their subordinate dependencies. Subordinate monasteries or other dependencies. The fourth verse of the second paragraph does not permit the residence in Mount Athos as monks of heterodox or schismatic persons. But this disposition can pose problems of compatibility with the European Union law concerning the circulation of persons in the territory of the European Union according to the relative freedom of circulation of persons. Paragraph 3 The determination in detail of the regimes of the Agion Oros entities and the manner of operation thereof is effected by the Charter of Agion Oros, which, with the cooperation of the state representative, shall be drawn up and voted by the 20 holy monasteries and ratified by the Ecumenical Patriarchate and the Parliament of the Hellenes. This paragraph 3 says that the determination of the regimes, the determination detail of the regimes, in the regimes means of the institutions of the entities of Mount Athos and the manner of their operation shall be affected by the charter, constitutional charter of Mount Athos. We have spoken already about the charter of Mount Athos. in the chart of Mount Athos, the determination detail of the regimes of the Mount Athos entities and the manner of operation is done. And then the same disposition provides the manner of adopting this constitutional charter of Mount Athos. The holy monasteries in the holy community vote that constitutional charter, and then it is ratified by the Ecumenical Patriarchate from the spiritual or ecclesiastical point of view, and from the Greek Parliament, from the administrative, state administrative point of view. In the paragraph 4, we read, faithful observance of the regime of the Agion Oros entities shall in the spiritual field be under the supreme supervision of the Ecumenical Patriarchate, and in the administrative under the supervision of the state, which shall also be exclusively responsible for safeguarding public order and security. The observance of the regimes, that is, the observance of the institutions of Mount Athos entities, in conformity with the Article 105 of the Constitution and the Constitutional Charter of the Mount Athos, shall be done by the Ecumenical Patriarchate as it concerns the spiritual, that is, the ecclesiastical sphere, and by the state as it concerns the administrative, state administrative sphere. The tasks of the supervision of the state, according to the appropriate legislation of Mount Athos, belongs to the civil governor or state governor of Mount Athos. State governor of Mount Athos is exclusively responsible for maintaining public order and security in Mount Athos. Paragraph 5. The aforementioned powers of the state shall be exercised through a governor whose rights and duties shall be determined by law. The law shall likewise determine the judicial power exercised by the monastic authorities and the holy community, as well as the customs and taxation privileges of Agion Oros. The paragraph 5 refers to the state governor of Mount Athos. And it says that this state governor exercises the powers of the state in Mount Athos. And also it adds that his competencies are determined by the relative law. Because the monastic authorities, that is the 20 sovereign monasteries or administrative monasteries, and the holy community also, exercise state judicial power, not only ecclesiastical judicial power, on the monks, qual residents in Mount Athos, but also state judicial power. For that reason, the law, that is the law which ratifies the Constitutional Charter of Mount Athos, determine the state judicial power exercised either by the 20 holy monasteries or by the holy community. Other laws also determine the customs and tax privileges in Mount Athos. Thank you very much for your attention.